Walzer is famous for developing that in a capitalist system, you know, the nature of red and clawed claw, the strongest win. And Goldman Sachs has given us an illustration, or maybe IBM, or so on. But they're not illustrations. They are illustrations of how the nanny state, the powerful state that's run by the principal architects of policy, designs policy in such a way as to enrich and privilege the designers. That's what I do with capitalism. I mean, there's a kind of a capitalist fringe to it. But what about Herbert Spencer? Well, at the same time, a little after Herbert Spencer, there was a response, much less known, namely Kropotkin, natural historian, who wrote a book called Mutual Aid, a Factor in Evolution. And he argued the exact opposite. He argued that on Darwinian grounds, you would expect cooperation and mutual aid and, to develop and leading towards community workers' control and so on. Well, you know, he didn't prove his point. At least as well argued as Herbert Spencer is. But in fact, Kropotkin essentially founded what is now called sociobiology or evolutionary psychology. But his contribution is sort of unmentionable because it came out of the wrong conclusions. Nobody could give right conclusions. Human nature probably had all of these factors in it. But some of them are favorable to the interests of the rich and powerful. So those do survive. Here there is, if you like, a Spencerian element. The ideological concoctions that are beneficial to the rich and powerful, they'll tend to propagate. The ones that are harmful to the interests of the rich and powerful will tend to be marginalized and suppressed. But that has nothing to do with the reality of the world. No, that has to do with how power systems function. But that has nothing to do with the reality of the world. No, that has to do with how power systems function. But that has nothing to do with the reality of the world. No, that has to do with how power systems function. Nobody can give right conclusions. But in fact, Kropotkin essentially founded what is now called sociobiology or evolutionary psychology. But that has nothing to do with the reality of the world. No, that has to do with how power systems function.